Hello and welcome to my channel today. I'm going to be creating a rusty mandala tag using products from Bee Crafty. All of the links to the products will be in the description box below. I'm starting off on a tag that I've made using mixed media paper, and I'm using the Mandala 2 inkable from Bee Crafty along with some deco art sand texture paste. I'm being quite rough with it because I want the whole tag to have a really rusty look, so I'm not worried about going over the edges of the stencil at all. I left the tag to dry overnight so that it was really, really hard by the time I got round to using it the next day, and I coated the whole tag with some silver acrylic paint. I didn't have a lot of paint left, so I added a little bit of water to make it go a bit further. Once this layer was dry, it made my metallic looking base coat, and I added some quinacridone gold acrylic paint, which I watered down and then dripped onto my tag. I wanted it to fall into the channels of where the stencil had been, and I added extra water so I could really get it flowing and really create a sort of dripped rust effect across the tag. To create the rest of my rusty look, I'm using three different acrylic paint colours. I'm using yellow oxide, burnt sienna and burnt umber. These are to create the three different sort of rust colours, the yellow, the brown and the dark brown. And I'm using a smaller stencil brush to stipple the paint on to really get a rusty effect. Once I'd finished adding those three colours, I wanted to add a little bit more of the original quinacridone gold again, because I felt it got a little bit lost under the other colours. As I'd added so many layers already to my tag, once I was happy with how the rust looked, I left it to dry for a couple of hours. Next, I decided to add a bit of background stamping. So I used the Bee Crafty Cog stamp set, and I'm using two shades of archival ink with these. For the larger cogs, I use the coffee colour, and for the smaller cogs, I'm going to use the sepia. Now, these cogs that I first stamped were quite light, but I was quite happy with them to be light because I wanted the cogs to sort of go into my background. I didn't want them to be a major sort of element on my tag. I just wanted them to create a bit of background texture and interest. Oh, also, just seeing this now, I added a little bit of black stamping as well because I just wanted some of them to stand out a little bit more. Now I'm using a piece of Bockingford watercolour card, and these are the Prima Metallics watercolour set, and I wanted to create a really watery background, so I'm adding lots and lots of water to my card and lots of water to my paints. I use the biggest watercolour brush I've got, and then I'm just adding lots of the different shades of gold to create a really sort of metallic mixed watery background. And to give a little bit of a patina type effect, I decided to do some splatters using the green shades in the set as well. Now, whilst I was waiting for it to dry, I did mix it up a little bit more. I'm now using one of my own stamps that I've designed recently for Bee Crafty, and this one is called Dreams Blossom. And I'm stamping it directly onto the watercolour background using the Wow Sticky Clear ink pad. I'm also then using this embossing powder, which is a pewter colour. I wanted to create some metallic looking flowers that went with the rusty tag. Now I'm stamping out one of the leaves, and in a moment I will also stamp out the sentiment from the stamp set, which says "Let your dreams blossom." Once I'd heat embossed all the elements, I decided to cut them all out, and I'm just going to cut one out for you here because I didn't think you'd want to see me cutting all of those elements out, but this is just to show you how simple the flowers are to cut around. I also did a little bit of shaping with my fingers. If you wanted to, you could get out your flower shaping tools and do even more. Once all of those pieces have been cut out, I then got the stitched borders and the dragonfly collage stamp sets, also from Bee Crafty, and stamped and cut out some of the different elements that I thought I might like to add to my tag as well. And now I'm using the Prima Decadent Pies watercolour set to add a bit of colour. So I focused mostly on using the browns to go with the rest of the tag, and then on the dragonfly I added a bit more of the greens and blues to create that sort of dragonfly colour that you would normally expect. Then came the fun part, the layering it all up together. I had had a little bit of a play around with the elements before I actually did my final piece to see where I thought I would like the parts to go. But this bit really is the fun bit because you can just layer them up, see what you like. I do tend to go with a bit of a sort of an L shape going on with my straight elements, and I do generally tend to create a cluster as a focal point, and also maybe things going across in a diagonal. That's how I choose to do it, but of course it would always be, you know, up to you how you want to lay out your elements on your projects. But I find that I tend to use things in groups of three because it's more pleasing to the eye, or else a group of five or seven, usually an odd number. The glue I'm using is a glue gel. It dries really, really firmly, and I like that it gives you a little bit of, well, quite a bit of wiggle room, because it does take quite a while, well, usually about 15 minutes to set a little bit, and then I tend to leave it overnight to make sure I've got a really good firm fix. But it also means you can add a bit of extra dimension as well. So if you want to raise your elements up but still have them really well stuck, this is a really good way of doing it. So I'm just adding in the circle elements from the collage stamp, and also some of the little paint brushes, just to add some extra interest amongst the flowers, and also to show that you can mix and match different styles of stamp sets quite easily, especially from Bee Crafty, because they're all such beautiful stamps anyway. But just have a play around and see what different stamp sets you've got and how you can mix and match them. Once I put it all together, I left it to dry, and I decided that it needed something to pull it all together a bit more. So I went back to the quinacridone gold and added some splatters, which I also sort of mixed in a little bit with my finger, just so that that rusty look went all over the pieces, and then they didn't feel so much as though they were an add-on onto a rusty tag, that they actually formed a part of it. I then wanted even more to tie it all together, so I'm adding some heavy body gel and these micro beads from Finnebear Prima as well, and I'm mixing the two together. And at the moment you see it's a sort of milky colour, but once it dries the gel goes clear and you just see the beads. I decided that the easiest way to apply them would be with my finger. I sometimes find it a bit too tricky using anything else. So, like I said earlier about the diagonal, I'm putting them in a diagonal line across my tag, and there are some areas where I'm filling in more, but I also wanted them to fall onto the flowers, have a little bit on top of the dragonfly, so that it's joining all of the elements of the tag together. And here are some final pictures of how it looked once it all dried. All of the products are linked in the description box. And if you have enjoyed this video, I'd love it if you could like the video. And also, if you haven't already, if you could subscribe. Thank you very much for watching. Until next time, bye bye.